What's up, divas and divos? It's your girl April, so you know what time it is. Y'all's hunties, y'all's. It is time for Real Talk Wednesdays, okay? Real Talk Wednesdays. And before y'all even ask me what hair this is, okay? Because I know it's cute. It's cute. This is actually from Forever Beauty, which is an AliExpress vendor, and it's actually a 360 frontal wig. I didn't make it. It's factory made, okay? So, yes, it's one of theirs. I did a video on it just now, and I was like, you know what? Let me just keep it on for the video because I was going to wrap a scarf around my hair and call it a day because a girl do like to put on her scarf and take this all off. But I said, you know what? I'm going to keep it on, and then, yes, she will be up on the website by the time you guys see this video, my hair website, you know. I will post her up there, but I put some tape on her. Let me tell y'all, y'all know what lace front, full lace wig tape is. A bitch got massive amounts of tape right here, okay? So this is a bag full of freaking lace wig, full lace wig tape, whatever. Tape, probably like 60, 70 pieces of tape in each little baggie, okay? Like, I am the tape dealer, all right? You know how they got like a drug dealer? A bitch is dealing tape, okay? So if you need some tape, hit me up and I will send you out some tape, okay? For real. I don't even know why I have all this tape. Like, seriously, it's just loads and loads of tape. Now, trust and believe, I didn't just buy this. I've had this from when I first started wearing full lace wigs on my first YouTube channel. And I know y'all like, but bitch, why did you need that much fucking tape? I don't even know. I don't even know. Okay, I know. I do remember this. One of that. This is not all from the same company. Some of this is from like this company where I used to buy hair supplies from. But then I got a lot of this tape from this auction that I had won on eBay. I think it was like 2,000 pieces of tape, and it was like all different sizes and shapes of the tape. So what I did was I put each piece individually in its own bag. You know, I put them together and I put them in a bag. So that's what I did. I don't know why I even bid on that freaking auction because this is a lot of damn tape. Like, you use this much tape, you won't have no hairline left. Like, seriously, this is a lot of, this is like my lifetime plus somebody else's lifetime of lace wig tape. This is, I'm dealing tape, all right? I'm dealing tape. Y'all want that, that China white? Because the shit is from China and it is white. I got it, okay? I'm dealing tape. That's what it is. I'm dealing tape. But I put some tape on the sides right here so it wouldn't flap for the video. And, you know, a little slicking it down here, whatever, you know. But it is a nice 360. I just think that everybody be going crazy over them for no apparent reason. Like, to me, honestly, they remind me of full lace wigs or glueless lace wigs or lace front wigs. To me, it's like all the same. It's like all the same. Seriously. It's like all the same. So anyway, yeah, that's basically it. So that's what this is. And she will be up on Going with the Wind Wigs website now. And other than that, I don't even know. There was something. Okay, so listen, Linda, listen. For real, listen. Y'all motherfuckers are gonna have to stop being so motherfucking nosy. Bitches be so nosy, they don't even know what they be talking about. Okay? Like, seriously. I'm saying this because I don't even remember what fucking video this was on. But did somebody ask me in this one video? She was like, and this is a recent video, okay? Like, a recent video. She was like, why are you always in your daughter's room recording your videos? Why you don't do your videos in your room? I want to see what your room look like. I was like, first of all, who told you it was my daughter's room, nosy ass? That's what I said. Like, because, bitch, what the fuck make you think this is my daughter's room? Like, I'm trying to figure out where she think this is my daughter's room at. Is it because I got colorful colors on my bed? A bitch can be 42 and have colorful comforter set. Why I gotta be so drab and boring? Is it because I got lights right there on my bed? A bitch can have lights too. Shit. Or is it because my motherfucking picture frames on the wall right there? You do see me over one of them right there. Yes. And my kids are surrounding me. Is it because they pink? Because a bitch like pink. I'm just trying to figure it out. Like, what made her think that this is my daughter's room? Like, my bed is a queen size bed. Though in the video, I think it, for some reason, it looks like it's smaller than what it is. Because when I watch it, it looks like it's like a twin, like a full size. But it's a queen size bed. It's a queen size bed. And everybody knows this is my room. Everybody on YouTube knows this is my room. Because where the fuck did she even get off saying, why you keep doing your videos and why you do your videos in your daughter's room? I should have said, bitch, why you being so motherfucking nosy? Why? You want to see my room so bad, you've been fucking looking at it all this motherfucking time, okay? All this time. If you go back to my old videos, you will see that same headboard. My bed is turned a different way and I got darker colors on my bed. What the fuck? Like, but here's the thing. The kicker was, I want to see what your room looked like. It's so crazy because, first of all, you so motherfucking nosy and you didn't even know the whole time, since what you want to see is what you've been seeing, okay? I'm trying to figure out what made her think that this is my daughter's room. That's the shit that I fucking don't like about people. Stop being so fucking nosy, okay? Stop it. Stop, okay? For real. There was something that I wanted to tell y'all and I just cannot remember for the life of me. Like, seriously, I cannot remember for the life of me. And as I sit here and try to think about it, I'm looking around my room like, tongue smacks. Bitch, is it in here? What the fuck is you talking about? Like, I don't even know. Like, I seriously don't know. Oh, well, whatever. So since I don't remember what the fuck I'm going to talk about with y'all, we're just going to get on to the video then. So if you have a real talk that you would like to talk about, then by all means, send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Please make sure to put in the subject line real talk, because if you don't, a bitch ain't going to open that shit. I mean, I will eventually, but for real talks, I will read it. You know what I'm saying? And then the way that I search it through my email, I would really rather it pop the fuck up. I don't even remember what I was... Oh, okay. So I stopped going to the YMCA gym. That place is so drabby and boring. Like, it was like a dungeon to me in there. You know, I got tired of hearing these old ass men that was like 50, not they're 50, but like 60 and something, talking about over there in the weightlifting area grunting. Ugh. I got so tired of hearing that. And plus I had my headphones in and I still was hearing it. On top of that, like at Planet Fitness and other gyms, when you're watching the TV, the equipment that you're using, you can plug your headphones in and get to that channel of the TV station or whatever TV station that they have playing for you to listen to. No, it's a Y. You have to download some motherfucking app and it doesn't even work. Their Wi-Fi there barely works, so it's eating up my data. It's very drab and boring there. Like, there's enough things to work out, but it was just like, you know, I would go there to get on the treadmill and the bike. You know me. I really wasn't lifting no weights. And when I did things that I wanted to lift every time, I couldn't get a chance to use them. And I was paying $40 a month for that, for me and my family. Nobody goes but me, and sometimes Tati will go, and you get free daycare. Tinky don't even want to be up in there. He done got kicked out 3 times for beating little kids up, and it's like, okay, you know what? I'm paying. I don't even want to go there. Like, I haven't been here in a month. What I have been doing is walking around in my neighborhood, because I live in this huge development, so it's huge. Like, when I say it's huge, it's like miles long. So it's like, you know what? Let me walk around here. So I've been walking 1.5 miles for like a week straight now, trying to strengthen up my legs, because my legs are so weak and shit. And I just really want them to be strong, because I don't want to get crippled. You know what I mean? I don't. But I've been doing that, you know. And plus, you know, I have arthritis in my knees, so I just feel like it's best for me to go out for a walk. So I do this walk in the morning time, and I also do it at night, 1.5 miles. So I get 3 miles in a day, which is really great. Also, tomorrow, by the time this goes up, it will be Wednesday. So today, rather, I'll be going to the orthopedic surgeon so that they can see what to do about my knee. because it be just killing me, and I'm just really tired of not being able to sleep like that. So that's the one thing that has been going on with me. Nothing major, you know what I'm saying? Nothing like that. Other than that, that's just about it. So let's get on to this real talk, because, yep. And, oh, I think I'm going to take a break from doing what everybody else needs to get done. You know, when you have it, like, in your life, like, you know, everybody depends on me. I do everything for everybody. I don't ask nobody to do anything for me. But when I need time to do something for myself, it's like a headache. And I have to do, like, a million and one videos in one day just so that way I could do what everybody else needs me to do. Like, you know, and I'm just so fucking fed up with it. But anyway, let's get on with this real talk, you guys. All the info to where you can email me is going to be in the description. Okay, so, hey April, first I would like to say I love your channel. I'm writing to get a third party's opinion on some things. I have a friend that we call Diane. I have known her for about 6 years now. When we first started hanging out, it was fun. She was adventurous, promiscuous, and approachable. If you went out with her, you were probably going to have a good time. I was around 24 when we met, and I guess I didn't really realize how out there her behavior was. Fast forward 6 years, and I really need to know the best way to kick her out of my life. Ooh, damn. She is 40 years old with 2 kids, and she dates men just for money. Whew. Has brought numerous men in and out of her kids' lives, is either drunk or on some sort of substance, and belittles me in very slick ways. She makes it seem that she is doing me favors, but really there is always a personal agenda behind it. For example, she would turn around and plan things like my bridal shower. Even though it was a half-ass effort, she would go on and on and on about how she did me a favor. Everything is about her. She talks shit about all her and our mutual friends and always gossips about their secrets. Since she is part of a circle of friends, I don't know how to get out of this friendship. Your advice would be appreciated. We're going to call her Marcy. So, as y'all already heard, they have been friends for 6 years. She's known her about for 6 years. And she's 40 years old, and she was around 24 when they first met. So, she's probably younger than this chick. What's her name again? Diane, I think she said her name was Diane. So she don't want to be friends with Diane. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to be your friend. Unfriend you on Facebook, bitch. I'm unfriending you on Instagram and blocking your motherfucking ass. Okay, so her friend is 40. Her friend be having men in and out of her kids' lives. Drunk, substance abuse men, whatever the fuck you want to call it. She's still promiscuous and adventurous, okay? On top of that, she be belittling her friend, shading her. You know what I'm saying? I hate shady ass bitches. I know some shady ass motherfucking bitches too. But she don't want to be her friend no more. Me personally, I wouldn't want to be somebody's friend who be shading, okay? That's the type of time schedule I'm on. I told y'all motherfuckers already, if I ain't your motherfucking friend in 2017, you already fucking know why. Don't be shading a bitch. Don't be motherfucking shading a bitch, okay? So, she want to know how not to be her friend no more because they share a circle of friends. So, here's the thing. We all grown. We don't have to end a friendship. But what you really need to do, Marcy, is let a bitch fucking know. Now, her promiscuous ways ain't cool because, you know what I'm saying? That's her shit. And that shit ain't cool for too long. And on top of that, you need to have a good talk with her. If you are some type of friend, whether you want to be her friend or not, this is how I would handle her. So that way, you know what I'm saying? She know not to come for me because I don't like no bitches coming for me. Not at all, okay? But what I would need for you to do, because this has happened to my so-called friend. She's the same age. She's a little bit older, and, you know, same situation. She be having men in and out of her life, bringing them home from the bar, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Same situation. Around her kids, same shit. Kids be acting the fuck up. You know what I'm saying? When your kids see that shit, you bringing this and that when your door, your front door is like a closet. You in and out of that shit. Niggas is in and out of that shit. That don't look good on your part. Like, I really wouldn't want my kids to think of me as no fucking thought or hoe. You know what I'm saying? So what you need to tell your friend, whether her kids are boys or girls, you need to tell your friend, listen, I'm not really feeling the way you live your life. That's your business. That's your opinion of how you do things. However, it's starting to affect me. I'm feeling like you being really shady towards me, belittling me on the low, and not thinking that I'm going to know that you're belittling me. How you talk about our circle of friends and gossip about them makes me wonder, is that the same thing that you do behind my back? 9 times out of 10, that's the same shit that bitch do to you. Trust and believe, because I did have a friend like that that I met through social media. She would do the same thing to her other friend, and then they be friends all over again. So I'm pretty sure, bitch, if you coming to me talking massive shit about someone that's supposed to be your friend for all them years, talking shit about them to me, and then you go around, turn around, be friends with them again, I'm pretty sure, bitch, that you dogging me the fuck out. I wouldn't put it past you, okay? In no shape or form would I put it past you. However, if you really don't want to be her friend, just let her know, listen, I don't really think that we should continue on with this friendship. And let her know the feelings of why. Because there's no reason to be shady like her, okay? No shade at all, okay? This is no shade zone, all right? No shade zone, no shade zone. Like, no flex, no shade, okay, bitches? No motherfucking shade. I'm sorry, but if she's sitting around you, talking with you about y'all friends and gossiping, then trust and believe, bitch, you ain't excluded when she ain't around you. Meaning she gonna talk about you too, all right? Whatever the fuck she can talk about. And a lot of people feel like they feel better when they talk shit about other people. They feel more, they feel better about themselves and what they do. It's like them trying to basically convince themselves that they're better than that person that they're talking about. You know what I'm saying? And I don't really understand why. Like, me personally, I don't give a fuck if you talk about me. I don't, you know why? Because you can say whatever the fuck you want to say, meaning it could be bad or good. You still thinking about me, then obviously I must be that important. Even if I'm across your mind and you talking some bullshit about me, I'm still across your motherfucking mind and I still must be somewhat important. Okay, so with her, with that type of shit, them are the females that you will just lose it with. And rather than show your other side that you really don't want to show, I would just basically, you either could have the talk with her about her ways and what type of woman she is, promiscuous, but however, if you do that, she gonna talk shit about you like you ain't even there. Okay, she gonna really have an attitude. So, and ain't nobody got time for that. Sometimes you gotta just like wean your way away from a person, meaning don't accept their calls, don't call them, and just wean yourself away from them. Sometimes that could be the best thing to do. I've had to do that in plenty of cases, you know what I'm saying? Wean myself away out of the situation with this friendship, because I know as a person that I am, if I really tell you some shit and you play fucking dumb with me, I'm gonna fucking flip the fuck out. So the best thing for me to do is to wean myself away. And that's what I would do. And what you would do is just wean yourself away from her. Not really have much to say. Don't converse back and forth with her. Don't communicate with her. She will eventually get the hint. You know what I'm saying? However, what she's going to probably wonder is what happened to y'all friendship. Or when y'all around y'all circle of friends. What's up? Why you ain't call me? Listen, the reason why I haven't been calling you, take her to the side, is because I don't really like the way you speak of people. Now, this is the thing I would do. Me, I would just wean myself from her. And when she asks you, I would just say what I said. The reason why I haven't been communicating with you or reached out to you is because I don't appreciate the way that you handle yourself, okay? Sometimes just to go to somebody and be like, I don't want to be your friend no more is because such and such. That's not really cool. You know what I'm saying? Nobody don't want to hear that shit. And it just brings more flame to the fire, whether you know it or not. So the best thing that you can do sometimes to a grown person is to step away and be the bigger person and wean yourself out of the friendship. You know what I mean? Eventually, if they keep calling and you don't answer, they gonna get the fucking point. If you don't communicate back with them like you normally do, they gonna get the motherfucking point. You have to wean yourself out of it. And when you see her in public, whether it be with your circle of friends or not, you need to inform her. If she asks you, why did you wean yourself away or why haven't I heard from you? Basically because I don't really like the way that you carry yourself. You don't have to use those words to be exact, because that could be a little bit harmful and them could be fighting words. Because I wish a bitch would say, I don't like the way you carry yourself. I'd be like, I don't give a fuck. Who is you? That's my attitude. But you know what I'm saying? The easiest, best way to do it for me sometimes is just wean myself out of the friendship and stop communicating with that person. Now, then you can also just be a trooper and just, you know, hey, listen, we need to have a serious talk. And maybe if you have a serious talk with her and let her know her ways and actions and the things that she says about people and how she carries herself, maybe that'll help her be a better person and your friendship doesn't have to end. You know what I'm saying? I would think about both of those options. Either you can wean yourself from her or you can have a good conversation with her. Sometimes a good conversation may work out for both favors to where you guys are still friends and she might have seen something at the end of the tunnel, a light at the end of that tunnel that really helps her. Because sometimes when you just leave a person alone, it doesn't help them. But sometimes you have to tell them, whether you don't want to or not, you have to tell them for their own good. Look, bitch, you a hoe. That's what real friends do, right? So yes, let Marcy know, how would you handle the situation if that was your so-called friend? Me, I just want to fuck with the bitch. I just wean myself from her. But you know, it is what it is. Okay, so next one. Hey, Miss April, I recently started watching your videos and you always had me cracking up with your facial expressions. I love you. So, you know what's so funny? My kids say that too, and a lot of people on YouTube say that. I don't really know what facial expressions I be making, but people be saying that my facial expressions is one to be desired. Like, you can tell everything by my face, so I cannot lie about nothing. And that's cool, you know what I'm saying? But I need your advice on this little situation. I'm Anthony. You can use my real name. So me and my mom always go to this Walmart by our house to do our grocery shopping and etc. We always see this one girl that my mom always just makes small talk to. We always see this one girl that my mom always just makes small talk with. She rings my mom up and our stuff all the time. And I'm always just on my phone and helping put the bags in the cart. So I just been in my little zone. So fast forward, my mom went in Walmart by herself one day. And that same girl was ringing up her stuff. So basically, the girl asked my mom, was I gay?
This is not the foundation.
That same girl asked my mom, was I gay or something? So my mom says, well, you should ask him. Which means, mind your neck, like you would say, Miss April. So I've seen this girl more and more after that working. So this time my mom and brother was in Walmart checking out in her line. So my brother told me that she asked, why I look so mean? And my brother told her that's just how he looks. But everyone tells me that same thing. Then after the girl did a little grind and turned Then after that, the girl did a little grin and turned her face. So the next time I see this roach, what should I say to her? I feel like this girl always got something to say when I'm not around. I'm not going to be in this girl line again and not say something. What she needs to do is continue to bag groceries and mind her business. Anthony is so cute, though. Who cares if he's gay or not? Because his eyebrows look so nice. Okay, honey? Eyebrows on fleek. So, first of all, Walmart Roach, all right? Walmart Roach asking Anthony's mother when he ain't around, is your son gay or something? First of all, and then asking his brother why he looks so mean. This is the thing I want to know. Bitch, why are you so concerned about my motherfucking facial expressions and what my sexual preference is, okay? Like his mother told her. You should ask him. Now, me personally, that's rude. You don't ask nobody no shit like that, bitch. We not friends. We not friends. You bagging groceries and ringing me the fuck up. That's your job. Do your job. Don't, let's not be Dr. Phil and be trying to fucking school somebody and fucking therapy some motherfucking body and counsel them. You know what I'm saying? However, I'm trying to figure out, does she like you? Because she may like you because she's asking, are you gay? Because you ain't trying to hit on her. I don't know what the fuck she looked like, but you called her a roach. And roaches is ugly. So if the bitch looked like a roach, I can see why the fuck you didn't hit on her. Especially if you were straight, too. A motherfucker wouldn't want to hit on a roach. However, if the bitch like you, that might be why she asked your brother, why you be looking so mean all the time, okay? However, and asked your mother. However, she went and overstepped her boundaries when she asked your mother your sexual preferences. That's not her business. I think your mother was real good with that shit, because I would have went the fuck off on a bitch, okay? It don't matter if you gay or not. Bitch, who the fuck is you to be asking me what my son's sexual preferences are? We ain't on no fucking shit like that. We not friends. I come to Walmart and I get in your line because you cool and shit, but you didn't took it to a whole nother level, bitch. We ain't cool like that. So, what you need to do, because she keep asking about you and your motherfucking business, next time you go to her lane, and I'm pretty sure you're going to be with your mom, you need to let her know nicely, because just remember, you with your mom, and we don't want to embarrass our moms, and we damn sure don't want them to get mad with us. But what I would say to her is, hey, I've been meaning to say something to you, or hey, I've been meaning to ask you something. That's what I would say. Well, honestly, I wouldn't say it like that, because I wouldn't be with my mom in a grocery store, so I'd say what the fuck I want to say, and a curse word or two or three or four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten might come out in that motherfucking sentence. However, since you with your mom, we're going to show mom respect and just say to her, you know what? Hey, I've been meaning to ask you something. How you doing today? Start off with a friendly conversation, because we don't want her to think that we already attacking her. But, hey, how you doing today? She replies, I've been meaning to ask you something. What is that? Or whatever the fuck she replied with. Why did you take it upon yourself to ask my mom my sexual preferences? What is it your business what sexual preferences I have? I'm trying to figure this out. What is it your business? So I'd like to know why you asked my mom, am I gay or not? How is that applied to you? I'm pretty sure that bitch ain't gonna say nothing. And if she gets smart, bitch, you at work. Don't lose your motherfucking blue apron up in this motherfucker, okay? Don't lose that motherfucking blue apron. Y'all know what the blue apron Walmart shit is. Keep the motherfucking khakis on, bitch, and steer clear of the attitude, because I'm asking you something. I would definitely ask her, what was it that made her ask my mom my sexual preferences? It's not her business. Now, some people in general think because you're so friendly with them and so forth, trust me, I know, that you can ask them whatever the fuck you want to ask them. Some people take that shit to a whole nother level. It be about nosy bitches. Some bitches be a little bit too nosy. They have no problem asking you your motherfucking blood type, if you got an EBT card, what your license plate is, your bank account, routing number, and how much money you make in a year. Some bitches have no problem asking all those fucking inappropriate questions, okay? For real. Inappropriate. But I definitely would fucking ask her, what is it your business with my sexual preferences are? There's nothing wrong with that question. And I'm pretty sure if she was to go report you or say something to her managers about you, okay, honey, you just asked my mom a couple days ago, was I gay or not? Why is it gonna make your life better if you know if I'm gay or not? I think, Anthony, I really think that she probably likes you, and she's probably wondering why you ain't trying to hit on her, or why you're not paying her no attention when you go in the lane. Maybe she's used to guys always smiling at her and hinting on her, but you ain't giving her no type of attention. You steady on your phone all the time. So that may be one reason that she might think you cute. And also, I think that she may have some type of liking feelings for you, might find you attractive, is because she asked your brother, why you always look mean. But you know, some people just have a way about going with things. If they like somebody, they really don't know how to actually say it. Like, just be yourself. Don't ask no dumb, irrelevant fucking questions about my sexual preference. You know, but I would definitely ask her, why are you always asking about me? Why are you worried about my sexual preference? You know, say it like that. Hey, girl, how you doing? I was wondering, why are you always asking about me when I'm not here? Why are you worried about my sexual preference? I'm just trying to figure that out. You probably gonna have her stuck on stupid. Like, she probably not gonna say nothing. Cause if you was to ask me why I'm worried about your motherfucking sexual preferences, I would probably be like, what? I would ask her. But when you ask her, just be polite about it. You know what I'm saying? Because you with your mom, and we don't like to be embarrassed, and we never like to be disrespectful to our moms. You know what I'm saying? I know when my kids be flying off the handle. I have a son and he's 18, and he has embarrassed me quite a few times out in public because of his anger issues with like customer service. Or you know, I've got a story where I bought this gold bracelet from this jeweler in Desert Sky Mall, and the guy told me to hold on. He had to go to his vault, and he left us in the store. Now, mind you, it's the mall. So he came back with it, and he tried to charge me more than what I knew it was worth. And so I talked him down, and then I bought it. Then, you know, he leaves the store, we leave the store. We go through the store and the mall, and there's like this section where it's kind of like a swap meet type of thing. That's what just what I'm going to call it, like a flea market portion. And there's nothing but Mexicans that work there, and they're selling all types of goods, jewelry or whatever. While we see this motherfucker giving back one of the bracelets that he came to me with. He brought 3 bracelets, and the other 2 he brought back to him. So we watch it. He didn't see us. So we walk away, and then we go back to the actual store where I bought the bracelet from, like, 10, 15 minutes later. Because I'm like, at this point, I'm like ready to return it. I'm ready to return it because I went to the flea market guy where he was returning the other ones. And I said, is this your bracelet? He tried to play stupid with me. And I was like, did the guy from XYZ jewelry store just come to you and bring you 2 bracelets back? And you had 3 and one of them was yours. Because I seen him giving you some money and returning some bracelets. And he was like, well, I don't know what you mean. I don't know what you mean. And so my son was like, you know what the F she mean. You know what the F she mean. Now, at this time, he was 17. So we left, and I asked him, how much is this bracelet worth? And he told me the amount. And I was like, oh, word? When I was like, oh, word, that means basically like, oh, you conned me out of like $150-something dollars. You know what I'm saying? So we go back to that store we get the bracelet from, we bought it from. And my son was like, listen, we want our money back for this. Now, mind you, this is the guy's store. He's the only one in there. He was like, no, no, no. And I was telling him why we wanted the money back. My son was telling him why we want the money back. He was like, no, 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 I didn't do that. I wouldn't do that to you. What does it matter if I did it? You got a bracelet that you like, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, he's like an Indian, whatever. He's talking. And, you know, mind you, there's a glass display separating us from him because he's over that side. My son got so angry because he felt like, yo, I don't know what happened. He was like, yo, you trying to play my mom? And the Indian was like, no, I'm not trying to play your mom. Next thing you know, my son grabbed him over the counter by his collar, had the little guy's feet dangling, and just, ow, knocked his ass the fuck out a good time. Had him dazed. The guy was like stuck, didn't know what to do. He was like, I'm calling security. We had to hurry up and leave the fucking mall before the security got there. And I was like, what the fuck is wrong with you? He's like, nah, fuck that. He could be playing you, stealing from you. I get it. You know, I was kind of embarrassed at the time. So I get it. So that's what I'm saying to you. Don't go in there cussing her out. Because like you said, she's a Walmart roach. And she's not even worth it. You know what I'm saying? It's rude. And very unprofessional to ask anybody while you at work, is your son gay? Like, what if you were not gay? Are you gay? I don't know what your sexual preferences is. I don't really care because that's your business. You know what I'm saying? However, what if you're actually gay in real life, but what if you weren't? And she says some shit like that. Like, I would just be so insulted. And like, who the fuck are you to be asking me questions about my son? Me personally, I would have went off on her for asking anything about one of my kids. Like, what? Fuck out of here with that shit. But you know what? When you in Walmart the next time, I wouldn't be fake and phony. I would just basically tell her, like, yo, what's up? I heard you've been asking about me. Why is it your business what my sexual preferences are? When you do this, that means you end up the conversation. That's the end of the question. And I'm daring you. Like I tell y'all all the time, when I say something to somebody in public and I be like this, that's me challenging you. Like, motherfucker, I dare you to reply back to that shit. It would be in her best interest and not to answer and just apologize. Be like, oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean no harm by it. But if the bitch give you some kind of snide answer, then you have to be like, what? Are you really coming at me like that? Where your manager at? That's it. You ain't even got to go off on a bitch. Because like you said, she a Walmart roach. And if she's going to be disrespectful like that, then you can call and find out who the high authority is over her. But I think it's rude. But don't go in there being fake and phony and not saying nothing. You know what I'm saying? It's your God-given right to say whatever the fuck you want to say. Shit, that bitch better not come smart with that blue apron on. I'm saying. Blue motherfucking apron. Okay, so the next real talk. Hey April, call me Peaches and my husband's name is Jay. We have been married for 10 years on the 25th of January. Oh, shit. What's today's date? Okay, so hold up. Okay, I'm doing that because isn't tomorrow the 25th? Like, all right, bitch, let me see something. I think so. I think, well, not tomorrow because it's Tuesday. It's the 24th. Yeah, so by the day this video goes up, it will be the 25th. So happy anniversary, Peaches, okay? So we've been knowing each other for 15 years. Jay and I have been in repair mode to fix our marriage. 9 years ago, I cheated with dude. Jay decided for the kids he would stay and try to fix our marriage. I realized that I am blessed to have such a great guy. Jay continues to bring up what dude told him about me when they spoke on the phone. Yes, girl, Jay called dude. That's the boyfriend she was cheating with. Dude told Jay truth and lies, but I had no idea. I love my husband and I appreciate the effort, but how do we fix this? If we can't move past the lies and if he sees me the way old dude sees me, I think we're done. But what real man would? I feel like such a fool for cheating and even a bigger fool for cheating on Jay. Can you please give me some muffin advice on how to move forward and fix my huge mess? I also feel like leaving to make this easier for Jay because I don't think he'll leave the kids. But he's totally unhappy. I love my babies, but Jay isn't happy, so he sometimes is distant with them. I feel so torn. Do I stay? Do I go? Do I continue to watch Jay walk around unhappy? Please help. My mother told me that a real mom never leaves her kids behind. What am I to do? Sorry for long complications. Life's complicated. Even if this doesn't make it a real talk on the tube, I still would like to know what you think I should do. Love, Peaches. Hi, Tongue Smacks. Hey, so happy anniversary, Peaches. I understand that you and Jay are going through some shit right now. This was like 9 years ago, though, that you cheated with this guy named Dude. We're gonna call him Dude. But you know what? I mean, sometimes some things hit people and they just don't understand what to do. It's like they don't know. It's like the unknown. You know what I'm saying? And with him, to me, it's more or less like the unknown. He don't really know what actually happened. And honestly, have you ever taken the time out to sit there and tell him, like, listen, this is exactly what happened. Instead of saying, oh, dude is lying. Dude is lying. That's not what happened. You know, you can say that all day till you blue in the face. But does that really make the person believe you? And even though you may not want to spill out all your dirty laundry to him because you know it was wrong. First of all, you have to keep in mind it was 9 years ago. And sometimes being a little bit more factual will help the person leave it alone. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, my ex-husband cheated on me. You know what I'm saying? He did. And I wasn't even trying to hear that shit. Like, nah, nigga, you done. It's over. But when he told me what the relationship consisted of, which was probably like a week or two, or not even, I don't even know, but you know what I'm saying? I needed some facts. Like, I needed you to tell me what the fuck you did with this bitch and all right? I need to know. And even though I still was hurt, because it was still fresh, it was like a week into the finding out he cheated, it still bothered me. However, at least I knew what actually happened in the relationship. What you need to do, because you love him and that's great, it's hard to find a good man. I tell you this, I kid you this not. Mine's might not have been the best man in the world because he had drinking issues, but I'm gonna tell you this, I love the hell out of my ex-husband. And you know, I have put him on blast. I have blasted him in so many negative ways because of just the anger that I have for him and the bitterness, you know what I'm saying? Because I held him down and I felt like, you know, he disappointed me in a huge way. So my only escape was to get divorced and like blast him. But in reality, you guys, you know, I love the hell out of him and I love him to this day. And I'm so glad that we are back together. We talk to each other and we are like really, really close right now. You know what I'm saying? So yes. Okay. But it's hard. Not everybody in a relationship is perfect. So if Jay thinks that he is going to move on with somebody else in life and find the perfect Mrs. Jay, it's not going to happen. However, a good old-fashioned talking will do you good, okay? Today is your anniversary, honey. I'm saying tomorrow because it's Tuesday when I record this, but today is your anniversary. What you need to do is just get him like some flowers. I know that may sound corny, but you know, I have sent my ex-husband, he was my husband at the time, flowers, you know what I'm saying? And write him a card. And in the card, just say, you know what? I really want to talk to you because I love you dearly. And explain to him the reason why you did this. You might explain it to him 9 years ago, but sometimes in a relationship, we need to have reassurance. We need to know that the person still loves us. We need to feel loved. We need to know that we're the only one, and we're the only one that they long and yearn for. You know what I'm saying? Because you cheated, he may feel like he's not good enough or he's not man enough. But in your heart, I know that he is, because you've explained it to me in this email. But sometimes we need just some more extra reassurance. You know, some people are not as strong as we may think they are. Just because he's a man, he goes through things too, and he has a right to have feelings as well, and he has a right to hurt. But you know, you don't, of course you don't want to see him moping around and just being unhappy, but you also want to get to the root of the problem. And if the root of the problem was with you and him and dude 9 years ago, then you really need to sit and have a great talk with your husband. You know what I'm saying? I personally wouldn't do it in the home. I would want to go somewhere where it's just private, meaning just private, like on a little weekend vacation. You don't have to go anywhere but to a nice hotel and just give him all your attention and shit. You know what I'm saying? That's just what I would do in this situation. Because sometimes just spending time with a person and giving them your all and letting them know exactly how you feel deep down inside when there's nobody else around, meaning no children, makes a world of a difference. Let him know how you feel about him. Sometimes we just need some reassurance. And though he may bring up that shit, he's not the only one. I have done that to my husband like 10 years after he cheated on me. I still was bringing it up, because that's what you do when you're angry. It's more or less like when I would do that to my ex-husband, like, oh, that's why you cheated, you dirty dick. That was like 10 years ago. Like, I would only do that because I would want to hurt him. And once I would say that to him, there was nothing he could say after that to me. You know what I'm saying? You can't say nothing after that. What you gonna say? Because you know you cheated. So what you gonna say? Whether I'm wrong or not about whatever we're arguing about, I throw that in your face, you quiet. What you gonna say? Yeah, that's right, I cheated. That's just gonna make the whole situation worse. So a lot of times we say these things because we just want to be hurtful at the moment. You know what I'm saying? To hurt you like you've hurt us. So just think about how he feels and how you would feel. Don't leave him because you love him. And don't leave him because now you don't want to see him walking around moping because it's you. You don't want to feel that guilt and pain. But you know what? Sometimes you need to, just to know where you stand at in a relationship and to let him know how much you love him. Me personally, girl, I would write a nice little letter and insert it in the card and let him know how I feel. And also let him know, listen, I made some arrangements for us to be somewhere this weekend or whatever on this date. And I need you to be there with me mentally and physically, because I need to talk with you about something that's really important to me. You know what I'm saying? You never know. That might make your marriage stronger, but I would definitely not walk away. Don't walk away because you can't handle his sorrow and his pain. Don't do that. Especially if he's a good man. Bitch, where you going to find some of them at? Nowhere. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you was wrong for cheating. Let's get that straight. You know that. And you know that. And sometimes you got to admit to your wrong. And you got to admit to saying, like, yeah, I know I fucked up. And I know I was totally dead ass wrong for cheating on you, because it wasn't even worth it. Sometimes you got to do that, though you don't want to say that because it might make your ego, you know what I'm saying, or whatever. Sometimes you got to admit that shit. I'm just saying, diva, be a diva, a strong diva, and just let a nigga know how you really, really feel. Okay? Yes. So, on that note, you guys, I hope you enjoyed this real. So, my dolls, sorry about that, because my memory card got a little full there, running my mouth. On that note, I hope you guys enjoyed Real Talk Wednesdays. I love you guys. Thank you for staying diva and divalicious and joining my channel. And as always, I will see you guys in a soon to come video.